of those four was Al-Imam Muslim rahimahullah. Let's look at what Al-Imam Ibn Taymiyyah said about this. Ibn Taymiyyah was asked, a question was put to him. They said to him, Al-Bukhari wa Muslim wa Abu Dawood wa Tirmidhi, these scholars, هل كان هؤلاء مجتهدين لم يقلدوا أحدا من الأئمة أم كانوا مقلدين؟ They asked Ibn Taymiyyah. They said to him, is Imam al-Bukhari and Muslim and Abu Dawood and Tirmidhi and Nasa'i, were they imams who are mujtahid? Mujtahid means they look at the Quran, they look at the Sunnah, and they extract rulings from it directly. Not looking at what anyone said, directly they go to it themselves. Or are they blind followers of a particular imam? Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah, he said. How many people was he asked about? How many individuals did they ask him? Today I'm going to put a lot of pressure on you, brothers. Today I want people to focus, not just today, but every class, inshallah. Yeah. How many people was Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah asked about? Hey, first was who? Bukhari. Hey, second was who? Muslim. Third was what? Abu Dawud. Tirmidhi. He wasn't asked about Ibn Majah. There's a reason why he wasn't asked about this. So these five, Ibn Taymiyyah, when he was put to him, he said, أما البخاري وأبو داود. Put Bukhari and Abu Dawood one side for me. What did he say? He's breaking them up now. He put Bukhari and Abu Dawood one side. What did he say? فَإِمَامَانِ فِي الْفِقْهِ مِنْ أَهْلِ الْإِجْتِهَادِ. Bukhari and Abu Dawood are mujtahideen. Are we all together, brothers? Bukhari and what? Bukhari and Abu Dawood are what? Mujtahideen. Well, I really want first of us to understand the people. The people are what? Number one is a what? Mujtahid. Okay. Second is a what? Muttabi'. Third is what? Muqallid. You have to understand this first. Mujtahid means a person who goes to the Quran and he goes to the Sunnah directly and he brings out a ruling. And he gives a ruling. That's a mujtahid. He has the ability. There are conditions lacking. There are conditions. It's not easy. It's not light. To just go to the Quran and the Sunnah and do bring a ruling like that. That's a mujtahid. Muttabi' is the second level. What does he do? He can't go to the Quran and the Sunnah himself. He hasn't got the ability. His knowledge hasn't reached that. But what does he do? He listens to the dispute and the discussion amongst of the scholars. He reads them. He just says, what does Imam al-Shafi'i believe in this issue? What's his evidence? What's his istidlal? How did he extract the ruling out of this evidence? Okay, I've understood him. What about Ahmad ibn Hanbal? Why did he oppose Shafi'i for? What did he say? Did he respond to this evidence? How was his response to that evidence? And then when he reads, he says, I am with Shafi'i. And Ahmad's wrong in this issue. He's a called a what? Muttabi'. Why is he a muttabi'? Because he couldn't go to the evidence himself. He couldn't go to the source himself and bring out the ruling. What did he do? He had to choose from the views that were there. He looked at which one is closest to the evidence. Are we all together, brothers? The third one is called the muqallid. Muqallid is the what? The muqallid is the one who doesn't know anything. He's like, as the scholars say, he is a مُغَسِّلٍ عِنْدَ مَيِّتٍ. He's like a dead body that's been washed. His hands been lifted, been put down. In other words, this, he just takes one imam's view and he just, everything he says, okay. He doesn't know if the imam is reading an ayah or if he's reading Arabic poetry, he can't tell the difference. What's he called? He doesn't know what's happening. Does that make sense? Huh? That's a muqallid. He doesn't know anything. Scholars, they, Ijma' ibn Abdul Barr brings it. Ijma'. In his kitab, Jami' al-Bayan al-Ilmi wa Fadli, that a muqallid is not considered to be people from the people of knowledge. It's Ammi. His words are not given a muqallid. Not a scholar. He's not considered to be from the scholars. That's the Ijma'. Are we all together, brothers? Also, a muqallid should not say this is right, this is wrong. Three, a muqallid shouldn't discuss anything. He is upon barura. When do you eat a dead corpse? Huh? When do you eat corpse? When you have nothing to eat, right? When you can't find food, what do you eat? Dead animal that you found. You can eat it because it's darura. Taqleed is darura, it's a necessity. So if you're eating corpse because you have nothing to eat, but I have food, you don't tell me, come and eat dead corpse with me. Are we all together, brothers? So the muqallid, he's upon darura, necessity. He's doing taqleed of his imam, he can't force other people to do taqleed, who are able to look at the evidence. Are we all together? Here now, Shaykh Hussam Taymi was asked, these five imams, Bukhari, Muslim, Abu Dawood, Tirmidhi, and Nasa'i, are they mujtahid or are they muqallideen? Ibn Taymiyyah corrects it straight away. What does he do? He gives two of them ijtihad. Who? Al-Imam Al-Bukhari and who? He says they are, Imam Al-Bukhari says, Al-Imam Bukhari and Al-Imam Abi Dawood are mujtahideen. They look at the evidence and they bring it out from there. And the other remaining, where did he put it, them all in? He puts them in, Shaykh al-Islam Taymiyyah, Ahlul Ittiba'. Tirmidhi, Muslim, and Nasa'i. They are muttabi'een. Yeah, they are what? Muttabi'een. Look what he says. He says, وَأَمَّا الْمُسْلِمُ وَالْتِرْمِذِي وَالنَّسَائِيُّ وَنَحْوِهِمْ فَهُمْ عَلَى مَذْهَبِ أَهْلِ الْحَدِيثِ لَيْسُوا مُقَلِّدِينَ لِوَاحِدٍ بِعَيْنِ مِنَ الْعُلَمَاءِ وَلَا هُمْ مِنَ الْأَئِمَّةِ الْمُجْتَهِدِينَ عَلَى الْإِطْلَاقِ بَلْ هُمْ يَمِيلُونَ إِلَى قَوْلِ أَحَدٍ إِلَى قَوْلِ أَئِمَّةِ الْحَدِيثِ كَالشَّافِعِي وَأَحْمَدُ وَإِسْحَاقُ وَأَبِي عُبَيْدَةُ وَأَمْثَالِهِمْ. They look at the views of those scholars. What did Shafi'i say in this issue? What did Ahmed say? What did Ishaq ibn Rahuya say? What did Abu Ubaid Qasim ibn Salam say? And they strengthen which one they believe is right and they take it. Are you with me, brothers?